under the idea that the Camry is a car for the boss, these seats will tell you exactly why. Now, it's a bench type of configuration right here in this particular setting, with the seat in the middle lying more on the functional side. But where you really want to be sitting is right here. Now, with this particular seat, what you also have here with the armrest folded down is comfortable space for four passengers. Here in the back with the armrest down, what you also have is access to your cargo capacity through the small pocket here. And with this up, you could also be able to enjoy your armrest. Now, for your armrest, it's a bit of a touchscreen affair here. Compared to previous Camrys where it was physical buttons, here now it's a more flushed and a more touchscreen look. Now, what you have here for your center armrest here is you have a touchscreen for all of the convenience features that you want. You could be able to adjust your audio settings, your audio preferences at any moment's notice here with all of the buttons. You could also adjust your seating configuration for more comfort. And if you feel like the sun's just a little bit too invasive, you could always push this button here. And what that does is it gives you a sunshade in the back to protect you from the harmful rays of the sun. If you want more insulation, what you also have is a mechanical shade on your windows. Now, in terms of space, here in the back of the Camry, as you can see, there's plenty of space for a tall guy like me, and a person can still comfortably sit here at the front. But the thing is though, if it's just me and my driver going to the office, what I could actually do is slide these seats up here with the push of a button, and what that does is that it gives me so much space here up front for me to be able to comfortably sit and enjoy the ride. But the thing is though, what if the boss likes to do his own driving? For that, let's move to the front and let me show you what the Camry's got. If you're going to be driving the Camry, this is what you have cut out for you. Now, when you start up the car, one thing you'll notice right away is that it's a pretty quiet startup sequence here inside, which is a bonus when you have a hybrid. But one of the things you'll also enjoy with this car is the steering wheel. The steering wheel actually adjusts to the previous driver's setting. It's pretty similar to the Lexus in that sense, and what that does is it makes getting in and out a whole lot easier. Now, going with the dashboard, you have your gear shifter down below and your three adjustable drive modes. You have Eco, you have Normal, and you have Sport, all of available just for you. Now, one of the things you'll also be able to enjoy is this large armrest here in the middle. And what can the large armrest carry? A small bag or even a pretty big hoodie. That fit in there? Now, for the steering wheel, what you have here is a mix of comfort and convenience. Now, you have a heads-up driver's display up on front, which is pretty cool because it helps you from moving your head too much, especially if you're gonna be driving. But for your driver's display, what you have here is a mix of digital and analog displays, giving you all of the important information that you have. Now, one of the more fascinating things I noticed with the Camry here up front is that you now have a pretty new look for your tachometer. Now, previously, what you would have is an actual tachometer on your left side showing you all of your RPMs, but this time what you have here on display is your power output. If you're charging, if you're on eco mode, or if you're on power, or whether you're activating your charging mode, because after all, this car does have regen braking. If you're gonna be looking for a Camry with paddle shifters, you might want to consider the TRD variant or the Toyota Supra instead. Now, aside from the adjustable function that I showed you earlier today about how this car turns on and off, you'll also enjoy the idea that for your steering wheel, you have a pretty nice leather wrap here, which gives you a lot of comfort, and the buttons are very intuitive and easy to learn. So that's the Camry in a nutshell. It's gonna be a comfy ride regardless of where you're sitting. The seats feel great for a luxury sedan like this, and it goes well with the tech, the ride quality, and the sound insulation. But now, it's time to get this ride on the road.